Hello, myself Ravikant Mangwadigi from Department of Collegiate and Technical Education. Today I am going to give presentation on topic Renewable Sources of Energy, Unit 5, Course Outcome CO5, subject is Environmental Sustainability, First Semester, Civil Engineering Department. Biomass. Biomass is a renewable source of energy derived from burning animal and plant waste. So, by burning the animal and plant waste, we get the biomass as a renewable source of energy. Biomass continues to be an important fuel in many countries, especially for cooking and heating in developing countries. So, this biomass is used for cooking and heating in developing countries. Biomass as renewable energy resource. Biomass is a key renewable energy resource that includes plant and animal material such as wood from forests, material left over from agricultural and forestry processes, and organic, industrial, human and animal wastes. The energy contained in biomass originally came from the sun. Through photosynthesis, carbon dioxide in the air is transformed into other carbon-containing molecules, example sugars, starches, and cellulose in plants. The chemical energy that is stored in plants and animals. Animals eat plants or other animals or in their waste is called biomass energy or bioenergy. So, biomass is a key renewable energy resource that includes plant and animal material such as wood from forests, material left over from agricultural and forestry processes, and organic, industrial, human and animal wastes. So, sources of biomass: forestry crops and residues, agricultural crops and residues, sewage, municipal solid waste, animal residues and industrial residues are the sources of biomass. Some advantages of biomass energy are: first advantage, biomass is always and widely available as a renewable source of energy. The organic materials used to produce biomass are infinite. Since our society consistently produces waste such as garbage, wood and manure, this is the first advantage. So, biomass is always and widely available as a renewable source of energy. Second advantage, it is carbon neutral. As a natural part of photosynthesis, biomass fuels only release the same amount of carbon into atmosphere as was absorbed by plants in the course of their life cycle. So, during the photosynthesis, the plants absorb the carbon dioxide and release the oxygen. Next advantage, it reduces the over-reliance of fossil fuels. Not only is there is a limited supply of fossil fuels, but fossil fuels come with environmental baggage, including the release of large amounts of carbon dioxide into atmosphere and the pollutants that result from removal, transportation and production. Third advantage is biomass is it reduces the over reliance of other fossil fuels, which emits the more carbon dioxide into atmosphere. Fourth advantage is less expensive than fossil fuels. While fossil fuel production requires a heavy outlay of capital, such as oil drills, gas pipelines, and fuel collection, biomass technology is much cheaper. Manufacturers and producers are able to generate higher profits from a lower output. So compared to fossil fuels, biomass is less expensive. Next advantage is biomass production adds a revenue source for manufacturers. Producers of waste can add value by channeling their garbage to create a more profitable use in the form of biomass energy. So converting the garbage into the biomass energy, it will be benefit for the manufacturers. Sixth advantage is less garbage in landfills. By burning solid waste, the amount of garbage dumped in landfills is reduced by 60 to 90% and reduces the cost of landfill disposal and amount of land required for landfill. Next is thermal characteristics of biomass as fuel. First characteristic is heat value. The heat value or amount of heat value in a fuel is one of the most important characteristic of a fuel, because it indicates the total amount of energy that is available in the fuel. The heat value can be expressed in one of two ways: the higher heating value or the lower heating value. The higher heating value, that is HHV, include the energy contained in the water vapor in the exhaust gases. The lower heating value, that is LHV, does not include the energy contained in the water vapor. Generally, the HHV, that is higher heating value, is the appropriate value to use for biomass combustors. Second one is moisture content. The low moisture level in the fuel is usually preferable, because high moisture fuels burn less rapidly and provide less useful heat per unit mass. Extremely dry fuel, however, can cause problems such as dust that fouls equipment or can even be an explosion hazard. Next characteristic is composition. In addition to heat content, other differences in fuel performance are related to composition of the various biofuels. The three most significant compositional properties are: first one, ash content; second, susceptibility to slagging and fouling; third, percent volatiles. Ash content. Systems that are designed to combust wood can be overwhelmed by the volume of ash can produce the combustion efficiency. Second one, susceptibility to slagging and fouling. Slagging and fouling means deposition of melted ash on the base and surfaces of combustion chamber. It can be minimized by keeping the combustion temperature low enough to prevent the ash from fusing. Third one, percent volatiles. Percentage of volatile in fuel affects the performance of the combustion chamber and should be taken into account when designing a combustor. Next is fuel size and density. The size and density of the biomass fuel particles affect the burning characteristics of the fuel by affecting the rate of heating and drying during the combustion process and should be given careful consideration when selecting a fuel type. The table, typical size and density of biomass fuels. Fuel, sawdust length 0.0003 to 0.002 meter length. Bulk density in kg per cubic meter 300. Chopped straw length 0.005 to 0.025. Bulk density is 60. Green wood chips length 0.025 to 0.075. Bulk density is 500. Wood pellets 0.006 to 0.008, 600. Biomass briquettes 0.025 to 0.010, bulk density is 600. Carved wood length is 0.3 to 0.5, bulk density is 400. Next is multiple choice question. First question is, biomass is a renewable source of energy derived from burning dash. Option A, only animal waste. B, only plant waste. C, both animal and plant waste. D, none of the above. Answer is C, both animal and plant waste. That is, biomass is a renewable source of energy derived from burning both animal and plant waste. Second question, biomass continues to be an important fuel in many countries, especially for dash in developing countries. Option A, cooking. B, cooking and heating. C, heating. D, none of the above. Answer is B, that is cooking and heating. Biomass continues to be an important fuel in many countries, especially for cooking and heating in developing countries. Third question, the energy contained in biomass originally came from dash. Option A, the plant. Option B, the animal. Option C, the sun. Option D, all of the above. Answer is C, the sun. That means the energy contained in biomass originally came from the sun. Fourth question is, through photosynthesis, carbon dioxide in the air is transformed into other carbon containing molecules such as dash in plants. Option A, sugars, starches and cellulose. Option B, starches. Option C, cellulose. Option D, all of the above. Option is A, sugars, starches and cellulose. That is, through photosynthesis, carbon dioxide in the air is transformed into other carbon containing molecules such as sugars, starches and cellulose in plants. Seventh question. As a natural part of photosynthesis, biomass fuels only release the same amount of dash into the atmosphere as was absorbed by plants in the course of their life cycle. Option A, carbon. Option B, oxygen. Option C, nitrogen. Option D, none of the above. Answer is A, that is carbon. As a natural part of photosynthesis, biomass fuels only release the same amount of carbon into atmosphere as was absorbed by plants in the course of their life cycle. Eighth question is, following are the advantages of biomass? Option A, it is always and widely available. B, it is carbon neutral. C, it is less expensive than fossil fuels. D, all of the above. Answer is D, all of the above. That is, it is always and widely available. It is carbon neutral and it is less expensive than fossil fuels. Next question is, fossil fuel production requires a heavy outlay of capital such as dash. Option A, oil drills. Option B, gas pipelines. Option C, fuel collection. Option D, all of the above. Answer is D, all of the above. That is, fossil fuel production requires a heavy outlay of capital such as oil drills, gas pipelines and fuel collection. 10th question is, by burning solid waste, the amount of garbage dumped in landfills is reduced by dash percent and reduces the cost of landfill disposal and amount of land required for landfill. Option A, 25% to 55%. Option B, 40% to 60%. Option C, 60% to 90%. Option D, 50% to 80%. Answer is 60% to 90%. By burning solid waste, the amount of garbage dumped in landfill is reduced by 60% to 90% and reduces the cost of landfill disposal and amount of land required for landfill. Thank you.